Mr. Dr. Adebolu, taking to the people, because it is often said that the people deserve the kind of leaders that they get. Are Nigerians doing enough by way of nation building? Because what many people have seen, including me, is somebody gets into governance, we elect him or her, and people hand over the destiny of the state to him and go back to sleep expecting him to do what is right for them.
Let me say the people are not doing enough. The people, as in what you call
Nigeria.
The masses. An average Nigerian is hedonistic. He loves life. He doesn't want to die. And that also accounts for why they refuse to hold their government to account. Who is going to bear the cart? Who will lead the protest? Apart from the fact that they are hungry, some are greedy. Hunger merged with greed, okay, and fear. These are the things that are working against the masses of Nigeria. Now, who is going to tell the local government chairman that, look, we need this road tar. We voted for you. We want this as dividend of democracy. When the local government chairman, each time he is passing by, he will spread some, maybe 5 naira, and people will be scrambling for it. So nobody will now go and tackle him. Is it the state governor who is always moving with a retinue of mobile police? Who wants to die? Who wants to lead the protest? Maybe the person who would have even led us is eyeing maybe a chief press secretary of the or something. He wouldn't want to talk. Or maybe one position or the other that is eyeing and he's already lobbying seriously. And this is the person that the whole community relies on to lead the protest. He cannot lead the protest because of his selfish ambition. So all these are militating against the people.
What about
they suffer in silence and they refuse to talk.
What about the community leaders, the religious leaders, the imams, the pastors, the local chiefs, and mbales, and emirs?
Tell me how many of them have not been compromised. Just name one or two.
Well, I don't know.
That has not been hobnobbing with the power that be. The moment you
they only say that they go to pray for them.
We also go to pray. So the moment you start hobnobbing the Elijah of old, they never hobnob with the Ahab and Herod of their days. They were bold enough to tell those people the truth from God. How many of them today have that liver to say, look, this is the judgment of God against you because you are oppressive to the people? Tell me how many of the pastors, how many of the imams,
are you my sense advocating that they mobilized like the Martin Luther King and the Jesse Jacksons of this world, Louis Farrakhan, I do beg your pardon, Malcolm X, to mobilize the people and organize them to take the leadership to account? Is that what you advocate?
We are yet to see that, and it will be wonderful, brilliant to have that in Nigeria. It is only then that our leaders will no longer take us for granted. Because they know that even the so-called people these people rely on beg us on a daily basis through text messages, through email, through sending representatives to come and lobby them for one appointment or the other. Who? They just look at the civil society and say, who among them that is not in our pocket? Who among them that is not at our mercy? I mean, that's the way the government looks at even the civil society. To me, it looks as if the so-called civil society now works towards a goal. Once I make enough noise to be recognized, I'll be called upon. And the moment you are called upon, you keep short. Unfortunately, this is the trend. And it is worrisome. Mm. That's the situation we find ourselves.